Hello Taurus, welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is your weekly reading from the 25th of February to the 3rd of March 2019 for the sign of Taurus, Sun, Moon and Rising, and also Venus. I hope you're well, Taurus. Here are the cards. I'm going to start with the Page of Cups, the King of Pentacles, the Six of Wands, the Nine of Wands, the Two of Wands, the Fool and the Five of Swords. I've pulled a spirit message and an angel message, and the overriding energy, two cards popped out, which is the Sun and the Five of Cups. So I'm going to start with, actually, the overriding energy. The Five of Cups is very much about mourning. Sometimes it can be living in the past, hankering on for things that have gone. This could be a relationship. This could be relationships, emotional attachments with people who you might have been close to at work. Maybe there's a loss of a job in certain respects for some of you. This can also be a loss of friendship. It's generally about relationships. But you see, there's two cups behind this person. It says there's opportunity around you. There's an opportunity to move on and see the more positive side of things. And this is about moving forward, the need to move forward. But I think you are. I mean, the Sun card, very much about forward movement, very much about a forward journey, being on the right path, finding your true self, shining bright in your light. That's what the Sun's energy is all about. It is also about revelation, nothing being hidden. So very much if you were not really acknowledging your capabilities, not really acknowledging how strong you are, not really acknowledging that you deserve love and that you're open to receiving love. This is about you learning about yourself as well. It's a revelation from within and understanding how to move forward, because, you know, this is very much about seeing the truths of situations. Nothing's hidden, but the truth of you, the fact that you do deserve love, you do deserve a career, you do deserve abundance, you do deserve happiness. This is a card of good news. So it's a really positive, it's probably the most positive card in the tarot deck. So it's a beautiful energy, Taurus. So very beautiful, yeah. So I think you're moving on from loss, from living in the past, to beginning to move forward. There's a turning point. I feel there's a turning point in you guys, certainly for some of you, where you're almost like beginning to push through those old boundaries, those old limitations that have held you back. So I've got now I've pulled some clarifiers with some of these cards. So I have the Five of Swords. This can be about a victory. I mean, you have two victory cards. Funny enough, I think I got this for another sign. So you have two victory cards. This is very much about a hard battle. And sometimes it is a question of whether it's worth it. But I kind of think with two victory cards being on here, you needed to push forward. I think there were clouds in your mind. Something wasn't right. These are clouds. Then the swords are very much linked to the mental energy. Something wasn't right. Something was making you feel negative, unsettled. And you had to deal with it. It could well be in the work situation. It could well be in friendships, or it could be in a personal relationship, husband, wife, partner. Something wasn't right for you, even girlfriend, boyfriend. And you had to deal with the situation and walk away. You had to deal with the truth of the situation. This can sometimes happen where you put things off and you just hope that things will resolve themselves by not saying anything. But there's that bubbling underneath. And sooner or later, you have to get that clarity on the situation. You have to make it happen. You have to be the initiator. And this is a situation that might have just happened, or it might have happened in the past. But I think it might well have been a relationship for some of you, though this can represent a partnership. It can also represent friendship connections as well. So, yeah, I mean, this can represent soulmate energy as well. But I kind of think that maybe there was some unsettled relationship that you had in the past and you had to deal with it because it wasn't making you happy. you weren't content. Maybe there was an imbalance in the relationship. It wasn't equal. So there was something that you had to deal with. And sometimes this means that you have to let go of people in order to move on, in order to release yourself from this unstable situation. But you are, you know, this is a wonderful card. It's a card of achievement. It's a card of breaking through. To me, this is almost kind of like the round wreath that surrounds this woman. This, for me, is almost kind of like breaking through boundaries, breaking through old limitations that you'd maybe self-imposed limitations. This person looks back at the journey. You can appreciate what you've been through, but you're now stepping into a new phase of your life. This is a completion. So you're bringing about an ending to a certain situation. I do think it's an ending to some form of relationship or partnership for some of you, but it had to happen. I do think it had to happen in this respect for you to move on, for you to be more secure in yourself. I'm going to move to the Page of Cups. Now, this is very much about change within you. Maybe finding that more emotional. You see how calm these waters are. The waters can talk about emotions. This is finding that calm emotion. This can also be about a change within you. Finding that peace of mind. Maybe being open to love again. Now, this is clarified by the Nine of Pentacles. You want to be independent. I think you want to go your own way. That's what the Nine of Pentacles is all about. Going your own way, finding your own abundance, feeling more grounded, feeling more focused in life after having a lack of focus previously, having somebody thrown you off balance. This is where you're getting that focus back, that beauty in life again, being able to appreciate happier times, I suppose. This can be also being open to going forward in a relationship, but it's very much at the moment somebody who wants to stand on their own two feet. And I think you'll surprise yourself. I mean, the fish popping out of the cup, there's a fun element to this. You may well feel that suddenly that baggage, that heavy weight shifts and you suddenly feel lighter, seeing more of the fun side of life after going through a period of difficulty. Just when all those clouds, you see there's no clouds in the sky here, all those clouds have shifted and you're getting peace. You're finding that peace, that sense of calm again. And again, another change card. You see, you do have a few pages in this reading. Pages are all about change, changing your circumstances for the better, pushing forward. I think you need to push forward. This is an obstacle that you needed to overcome. And you're determined to deliver success, happiness, prosperity, abundance, maybe a relationship in your life, finding that desire again. The ones can very much be about desire and passion. But I also think in terms of business, this is about finding that growth, pushing forward, even though you're tired, even though you've had to dig deep to keep on moving forward. This is somebody, it says that you're closer than you think to moving forward. And change is coming. I think change is coming maybe on the career front, maybe on the personal relationship front. It might well be finding that passion again within you to move forward and change things for the better in your life that you want to be changed. So yeah. And the one sprouting, talk about expansion and growth. So whatever you're putting your mind to, there's a real possibility of really starting the road to success. And obviously we saw the Nine of Pentacles. This is about finding that abundance, but I think it is about you standing on your own two feet. You beginning to find your power within you again. Even though you've been pushing forward and you didn't feel that you had that power within you, it was draining, you didn't know if you had that resolve. This is you finding that again. And I do see this because this is the Two of Wands. Finding your power, grabbing your opportunity, the Wand of Potential, and beginning to look at your world and see how you want to change it and make it better. This is like a life review. This is about looking into the distance, having the world in your hand, and deciding how you want to go forward, whether you want to bring a relationship into your life, whether you want to attract money, whether you want to be more successful in business. This is where you are standing and really looking into your future and seeing what does it look like to you. And the road's been tough, but it's an ending. The weight's gone, and this is what I was saying. The weight of the past, maybe past difficulties with relationships, it's gone. This is over. It's a 10. You've had to walk a difficult road with a heavy burden. But this is saying it's gone now. This person has no baggage, and they're now looking forward into their life future and seeing, do I want a family? Do I want a relationship? Do I want more money? And bringing it to them, there's opportunity to bring in expansion and growth. I'm going to go to the King of Pentacles because, oh, these are beautiful energies. So I kind of think I'm going to start with this card. The Six of Swords, you're in a life transition. This is a transition period. But I kind of think you've got clarity now. You know where you're going. Having gone through the Five of Swords energy, this is the Six of Swords. You're restoring balance in your life. Sixes are about balance and harmony. You're going from choppy waters to calmer waters. You're feeling more calm within yourself. You have clarity on where you're going now, whether it's in business, whether it's friendships, whether it's a personal relationship. You know where you're going. And you see, this is a family, this is a child and a woman as well. This is, you know where you're heading in relationship terms as well as business. So you have that clarity and you're moving out of troubled waters. You're heading to calmer pastures. And I think you're opening up to the universe because the Empress is about creation, the ability, and you do have pages in here which symbolise change. This is very much about being open to maybe starting your own business, maybe starting a new relationship. You see how she's reaped her harvest. This is about planting your seed now. Whatever you do now, you have the ability to transform your fortunes into something that will grow and give you great rewards. This is also about being able to attract wealth, prosperity, the know-how. You're almost like a magnet this week. Well, certainly, it could be a few days either side of this week, could be a few weeks, to be fair. There's no timing in terms of divine law. However, there is magnetism around you now. This is somebody who knows how to bring in love into her life. She's Venus. This is somebody who knows how to bring wealth into her life, surrounded by beautiful things. This is somebody who finds balance. This is somebody who understands how to attract career progression, success into her life. And this energy is with you, so there is an element of understanding how to attract whatever you need into your life now. You have the know-how to attract your opportunity, your desires, and manifest it in the real world. This is a card of monetary success. This is a good problem solver as well, actually. Any obstacles will be met with some of you who probably understands how to, more capable, more clear-minded on how to solve any obstacles that come in your way. This is also, it could be somebody in your life that's helping you, maybe helping you financially. It could be somebody who is giving you support, being practical, grounded. But this is a real sign of success. This is manifesting wealth, prosperity, abundance. This is money as well for some of you. Money coming into your life, maybe after a period of difficulty. Successful times ahead. And we have victory, riding forward, another six, finding that harmony, that balance in life now, moving forward with courage and strength, being respected by people who care about you, who support you, who love you. This is moving forward with an open heart as well. So yeah, it's a beautiful energy. So a real victory card. And there's a change within you. You're feeling that ambition, that drive again. You see, I call this the Winds of Change card. You see how the winds are just blowing to the right. You're getting clarity of mind. You know where you're going. You're grabbing your sword of truth, your sword of clarity. You see the path before you. You know where you're heading. This is a card of going for it. Whatever you want to go for in life, this is a time to go for it. It's time. Now's the time. And Six of Cups. This can be about a new love coming into your life. This could be somebody from the past offering a relationship again. And it is your decision whether you want to take that or not. This is somebody who... This also represents remembering happier times and going back. Almost kind of like finding that happiness within you again. Finding that more positive, happy, joyful. Very much like you were like a child. These are children. And this is almost reconciling past difficulties with the present and being more open and optimistic about the future. So very much about how past influences can come back to us and we can achieve that happier state of mind again after a period of difficulty and find that balance. And that's the victory. So it's a beautiful energy. So the angel card, I've got prioritize, Archangel Metatron. Focus on your highest priorities. I will help you get organized and motivated. Beautiful. And I've got a spirit messages card here. This says dream talk. Your subconscious constantly and subtly speaks through your dreams. It's just one of the many ways in which your soul and those here in the spirit world can reach out and communicate with you through signs, symbols, messages and more. It's beautiful energy. And remember, this is divine. This is divine energy as well, the sun. This is you beginning to find your power again. Feel more, you see, I'm looking at this circle, feeling more complete as well. Feeling more complete and whole. This is where the sun's energy, the power of the sun, the natural power, touches you on earth. And you feel that natural power within you again, that power rising within you. And it's not power in terms of authority. It's that power of self. And it's such a turning point, I think, for you. So it's a beautiful reading, Taurus. I hope you enjoyed the reading. If you did, please do like, share and subscribe. I hope it's a great week and I'll see you next time. Thank you.